Hi friends, how are you? I hope you started your week really nice and all of you are doing very well. So friends, this is another channeling which came out about a day or two back, you know, and I'm relaying this to you right now. So what I got in the channeling was through the universe. The universe was telling me where the couple is regarding in the current energies, the current day, current times and overlapping channelings. So let's begin with the channeling, folks. So what I'm getting, folks, is that the divine feminine till now, she has been going into a detachment like phase, which means that she is, many of you are kind of giving up, throwing the towel. Many of you are just feeling that it has taken too long and you don't want to invest your energies and time in it any longer. And many of you are just coming to the empowerment that, you know, the similar feelings or similar romance can be given to you by another person. And many of you are also coming into the realization that you actually don't even need another person at all to live this life happily, you know. So whatever the case, whichever category you fall into, you know, or even the category where you are still holding space for your twin and still feeling very romantically regarding your masculine twin, any category that you fall into, what I'm being shown is that particularly the category which was finding themselves detached, you know, the feminine bodies or feminine energies which were finding themselves in a detachment, now what is happening is that they are feeling the connection with their divine masculine again. They are feeling that romance again, they are feeling that telepathy again, they are feeling that connection with their masculine again, and also they want to build up on that connection again. It is like this was a phase of cleanup or a detachment phase when you had to stay away or when you had to actually literally give up to actually clear up all of your gunk, your energies, to be able to come into that realization or that feeling. That feeling organically, not by pushing against it, but coming to that organically in its natural path. Now you're feeling that love again. Now you want to build up on that connection again with your twin flame, and you're feeling that romance again for your twin flame. Whereas in the past, you were feeling all the anger, resentment, and a lot of resistance and pushing back and not wanting to be with him. Thinking about all of the past things that he had done, and they were like stab wounds in your heart, you know. So you could not, when you even thought of connecting with your twin, connecting meaning energetically connecting, feeling his energy while you're sleeping or feeling his sexual energy while you're going to bed or rest of the day, you were not ready to feel him. You were not ready to feel his energy because you were thinking of all the things that have happened in the past between you and him, and you were resentful, you were holding anger. So when you hold anger, you push back against the person, you know, any person. So you were pushing back against your twin flame, but now the energies have started mellowing down, and they have mellowed down to that extent that now I am being shown the feminine is actually telling the masculine energetically, or the divine feminine collective is telling the masculine collective that she wants to impress or seduce the masculine again, you know. She is coming back into those romantic, sensual, sexual energies where she again is trusting or believing that the divine masculine is her true counterpart, and she wants to have all that romance, all that impressing him, all that, you know, seducing him. And this does not mean to go that the divine masculine is on some pedestal and you should have to impress him in certain ways. No, that is not the meaning of this channeling. The meaning of this channeling is that now the divine feminine is coming into those goddess-like energies that she is feeling connected with her own body at first, which means a sensual connection, a energetic connection, or even a sexual connection. She has consolidated all those energies in her body. Now, because she has consolidated and also come to terms with those energies in her body, that she does hold a divine counterpart, she is expressing or projecting is the word, projecting the same energies to the divine masculine. Now, if you do not know what projecting is, you can search projection, P-R-O-J-E-C-T-I-O-N, projection in DSM, D capital DSM, projection in DSM criteria, you know. That will give you some kind of a tabular information or something on what projection is. You are feeling that love for yourself, you are feeling that connection for yourself, divine feminine, and because you are feeling that connection, that loving connection for your own body, because you have reached empowering states, you are also projecting that to the twin flame. Now this projecting is not untrue. You want to feel him again, you want to seduce him, you want, and this does not mean literal seducing. You want to seduce him in energy, you want to impress him, and you want to tell him that you are really mad about him, you really care about him, you know, you're going gaga about him, and you are becoming more vulnerable, you know, which you had become closed off in the past few weeks, or I'm being shown 1 month, particularly for those people for whom in the past month they had become very closed off and they had totally detached and they had totally kind of run away from the connection. Those feminines are now again singing and dancing like a sensual goddess in front of the divine masculine, inviting him again to the forefront, you know. They are inviting him again to the forefront and in a very romantic, passionate, sensual way. Now, this should not be taken in a very derogatory way that the feminine is like a goddess dancing in front of the masculine and this and that, you know. Try to take the true meanings about what the channelings are all about, you know. I will never go away from empowerment and feminism, you know. So I will be the last person who tells a female to do something to appease or impress the masculine if it is not time of the day. So what is happening is that she's so happy in her own life, in her own, you know, energies. She's becoming so good that she now is again connecting with the love energy. See, if your basic security is not there, if you're feeling very bad, or if you're feeling very like, you know, you have so many issues about self-doubt, rejection, you know, patriarchy, matriarchy, this and that, you're not going to think about romance. Come on. If anybody is even half as intelligent as the average intelligence should be, unless you have all the things which are called inner work figured out and you have healed yourself enough, you are never going to be able to think about the finer things in life, about eating oysters or about thinking about romantic love. You can think about your twin in a way that, you know, these are the blocks between us, or his mother is preventing us, or this is happening, that is happening, but you will not be able to think about the romance part, the kissing, the sensuality between. You will only be thinking about the romance or impressing him or seducing him only when your energies are clear. I hope you understand that this is a very, very regular practical thing, you know. You cannot think about sexuality. Even your sexual drive goes down if your basic security in life is not there, you know. So what is happening is divine feminine is connecting so well with her own body that she is trying to sensualize the whole thing. The romance is turning up again. The romance switch is being turned on again. Whereas on the divine masculine side, what is happening is that he is awakening to the fact that you are his counterpart. He's awakening to the fact that he also wants that romance with you. He's awakening to the fact that he is seeing that you are so vulnerable for him, and that you're telling him that you're mad for him, you're, you know, going crazy for him, and in a very good way. It is like you're singing that, you know, you know, I'm really mad for you and I really want to connect again with you, the romance and everything. You know, but what is happening on his side, that he's still stuck in the energetic phase, meaning that energetically he knows that he wants to reach you, and you are the counterpart, and he also wants that romance, that sensuality, that sexual element. But what is happening is that from his energy to the manifestation stage into his physical reality is not happening yet, because there are still some karmic patterns, not partners. There are still some karmic patterns in his side. And what do karmic patterns mean? karmic patterns means that there are certain blocks which are still keeping him in that energetic form and not letting it manifest into physical reality. Now these karmic patterns for many of the masculine twins, I would say 80%, which is being given to me by the universe, this is a number, 80% of the masculines are still stuck in karmic partnerships. Now this is not patterns. Karmic patterns include addictions, blocks, as well as partners. Now 80% of the karmic patterns are karmic partnerships, which means there is another female or male on the other side. They might not be together at this point, but the energies are still lingering, meaning your twin might have broken up with her, but he is still in the dejection and the rejection of it. I hope you understand. There might be, they are saying that 30% of the divine masculines are still in active physical relationships with the karmic partners, but they are saying that 50%, now the total they gave was 80%, now they are dividing it into 30 and 50. 30 are actually in active karmic partnerships and 50% of them have already broken up or filed for divorces, but the energy of that karmic partner, that person who destroyed him, is lingering with him because he is totally dejected. Not because he loved her so much, but because of the cheating and the deceptions that he has faced from her, he has lost trust in life. So you need to be extra compassionate at this point, and that is why the universe is making the feminine energies work in such a way that the feminine energy is trying to appease or impress or seduce the divine masculine to actually bring him out of the gunk. Now you see how again both the twins are mirroring what each other needs. The masculine twin needs the seduction, the dance of love, the dance of romance right now from you, and what you need is for his energy to build up through your dance and romance so that he can actually manifest the energy into a manifestation of physical union. He already has you in mind and he already has the union in mind. Like I said in this channeling, he is already awakening to the fact that it is you. You know, it is you. It is all about you. It has always been about you and him, you know. He is awakening, but he cannot yet put the energy into manifestation. Why? Because his energies are very low at this point. He is dejected and rejected from another party. Now, instead of pushing back on him and hating him, what you need to do is you need to increase your song and dance and romance. You need to become a bimbo for once in your own energy, not in person. You need to send him those higher energies so that your higher vibration can make him rise his vibration, so that the energy of union can be manifested into an actual union, because you yourself are the creators of your union besides the inner work which you have to do with another person. So I hope, folks, you found this channeling very valuable and you will get valuable lessons out of it. The song and dance is there from the feminine. She's trying to appease and seduce the masculine again because she has found newfounded interest in him again. The interest has come back again. I congratulate all of you who are feeling that way. And because of your song and dance, the vibration will be higher on his side also, because he will mimic it. And as soon as the vibration starts to rise, and as soon as you reach a pivoting point, the vibration has to reach a pivoting point. As soon as you reach a pivoting point, it will tip over and you will find the manifestation of the physical union at your doorstep. Thank you so much, friends. All of your personal readings are being done. You don't need to contact me single-handedly. All of them are being done and they will reach you in the time that is meant for them to reach you. And for all personal readings, you know that the information is down below in the description box. You have to use PayPal yourself to pay and then send me your story in 300 to 500 words. That is what you have to do, and you don't need to contact me for permission to obtain the reading. You have to just use PayPal, send me the story, and that is it. You are done. After that, you don't need to inquire and you will get the delivery in due time. Thank you so much, and I hope you found the channeling valuable. Many kisses, God bless, and I hope you started the week very nicely. Much love.